We're going to see how we can use this camera with a servo so anywhere we turn, it stares at us by rotating the camera. Hi, welcome to a product tutorial by Robojax. This is SunFounder's PICAR-X Raspberry Pi self-driving robot car kit.
Hello friend, how are you? Turn left here. Count up to 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Rock. I'm lost.
When you come to docs.sunfounder.com, you will see this page. Scroll down under the robot kit. You will find PICAR-X car kit version 2 with battery. Click on that. On the left side, you will see different options. Select play with Python. And all our lessons are listed here. We will proceed from here. The documentation page, when I click on, you will see number 8 stare at you. So this project is based on computer vision, which we saw it, and we can view the video from this by going to the IP address and then :9000 mjpg. We're going to run this code from the VNC or from the remote desktop by going to the example directory and then run this code number 8 stare@me.py. And here is the code explanation. We are importing PICAR-X from PICAR-X library. We are importing this class, and then from time we are importing sleep, and then the vision library is imported from PICAR-X. We are creating this object PX. This is the name of the class, so we are creating that object. We have one method here, another method main starts from there and then goes down up to here, and then this will run our code, and this portion finally runs if there is an exception or error in the code, and it will stop. When the main code runs, it comes here. We are creating camera starts from vision library, so this is starting the camera, this is displaying the video. This line initializes the face detect switch pass through, and it is initializing. And we have defined two variables, angle X and angle Y. And this is a continuous loop. We see here F detect object parameter if detects a human face. So if this is true, then we do up to here. Else, we have half a 50 millisecond delay and it goes back. And then we get the detected object, which is human. We pass human position of X of it. So that's called coordinate X. And then the same way Y. Change the pan and tilt angle to track for the object. So we are converting this X based on the resolution of the video. And then we have some just 5 pixels subtraction, perhaps for the surrounding pixel. the angle for this servo doesn't go beyond 35 degrees because it can go up to maximum 45, and here they set it to 35. So from here, 35 is positive under zero and the negative 35. For that, we have to make sure that the servo doesn't go beyond that. For that, we pass that number and we say this is the number and it should not go beyond minus 35 and 35. So it goes to clamp number method. It comes here, and using this method, it returns the value which is maximum from the minus 35 and 35. So this is just returning it and preventing it not to go to the beyond these values. And this angle comes and we pass it to this method called set cam pan angle. That's a pan angle, and the servo will move in X direction, and here either it goes to this way, to the right or to the left. But then we have the next step, which we have to send also the tilt up and down based on the position of face. So now the video resolution is 640 by 480. So that's the width of our video. I'll show it here. And then 480 is the height of our video. And we are getting the coordinate for the Y angle using this formula. And we are adding it to the Y angle variable at the top. So we are subtracting it here, not adding. And then again, we are using clamp to make sure that minus 35 and 35 is respected, because the middle angle is zero, and then we have 35 and then minus 35. So we have to make sure it stays within that bound. So once we got the angle, we send the servo using set cam tilt angle. So this is sending our camera tilt angle with the angle that we calculated. So job of this was to just send X and Y at the position of the coordinate which was coming from the video, from human face at X and Y position. First, let's find out the IP address of our robot. Go to PowerShell, right-click and run as administrator. And let's type ping minus 4 robojax.local. That is the host name that I set. IP address is 192.168.0.102. Open VNC player. We have shown you how to install it. And 192.168.0.102. Enter the IP address. You will get the warning, accepted. Enter your username and the password. I've selected username and password, and then click OK. Here is our screen. Go to the terminal. Now let's open the command line, type cd PICAR, PI and then EX example and enter. If I run dir, this time we are running number 8. So sudo python 3 8 and then dot completed. Now the code is running and it's running at the camera. I have here a picture. Let me just put it close at some distance so you can see it. Now this is the camera. If I move it that way, it goes, and as you can see, it follows the face. And to show you from this side, making sure. Now, to show you from the side, pay attention that if I go up, it goes up. And if I bring it this way or that way, it detects it. Now we are going to have a look at the screen here, so you can see that if I go to the left, still the camera is following me. If I go to the right, and still the picture is on the screen and the face is detected. This is so cool. You can use your browser and type the IP address 192.168, whatever is the IP address, and at the end type :9000, that's the port number, and then MJPG. So this is the video. Here is my hand. And then I'm going to bring this in front of the camera. As you can see, the camera is following it. If I go to the left and then go up and then down, making sure if I go a little fast, it cannot follow. So you have to go slowly. That's not bad. Here, and I've typed the same thing here, 192.168.0.102. That's my IP address. Yours will be different. :9000, and then /MJPG. So this is the camera now. The camera. So it detects it. And I'm streaming it on my phone. Perfect. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next lesson.